Hey, welcome to another great episode of the Fan Club. It's your boy D-Braz, Dan Brazen in the building. How we doing? How we doing tonight, folks? We're going to be talking about something close to my heart tonight. We're going to be doing a season preview right before the preseason starts in a few days of the Minnesota Vikings, okay? Now, this team has gone through hell and back. They are on the rise, in my opinion, because they have been down. They have been knocked down. They were off to one of the hottest starts in the league last year. The defense in the first five games was compared to like the 85 Bears with what the sacks and interceptions, turnovers, everything. And then the offensive line got hurt. Guys stopped playing like they were supposed to, and the offense turned into a big zero. Couldn't do anything. Sam Bradford couldn't get the ball out of his hand fast enough. We had the running backs. No one knew who was going to be the starting running back any week last year because they all sucked because AP was hurt. And, you know, tip my hat to Asiata. He's a one-trick pony. He can rush in for touchdowns. You know, he gets you some yards, but he's not a every down starter, and neither is McKinnon, even though I think he's explosive on plays. I like how he catches it, but I think he's a perfect third down back, okay? So now we're looking at the Vikings, and we all know, except for people, I guess, didn't really tune in last year, the Vikings started up like 5-0, 6-0 or something. They didn't make the playoffs, guys. They went 8-8 for the rest of the year, and they lost game after game after game. The second half, they could not put it together, okay? But a team that did the same thing a year ago before was Atlanta Falcons. They started off super hot and went 8-8, and then they made the Super Bowl this past year. I know that's not the greatest comparison because we know all what happened there, but it shows you that you can bounce back from something like that if you sign the right people and you learn from your mistakes. So we're going to get right into that. First, we're going to talk about signing and letting go of the right and wrong people. You know, sometimes when you sign people, it can be a poison or injury prone. You just paid a bunch of money assets to somebody that's not giving you anything. We're going to get right into that because this was the offensive line last year. We could not do anything last year because everyone was injured. So we're going to talk about some stuff. Right away, we let Matt Khalil go. Let him go to Carolina, and they paid him a ridiculous amount of money. I think it was like a $50 million deal or something. It was a lot of cash. Then we got rid of Brandon Fusco and Mike Harris. All these guys were just, they weren't that good. And so we picked up Riley Reiff and Mike Remmers. These guys are solid. I think that these guys can come in and really help with what we're doing. I think it's all about the line. Subtracting is sometimes an addition. Get rid of Khalil, bring in a couple guys, make sure they're healthy, and bring them in and let them do their thing. We agreed to terms with Terrence Newman, upgraded a little bit of our defense, but we're going to talk about defense in a second. We're just going through what we did. We re-signed Adam Thielen. Great player. I don't think he's a top guy any year, but the guy just works his butt off. He is a favorite, especially to Sam Bradford. Very, very good player. He is a reception monster. So check out Thielen, even in fantasy leagues in later rounds. So then we are going to get into Case Keenum. Now, I'm not going to talk a lot about him. We know Case Keenum isn't the best, but as your third option, if anything happened to Bradford and Bridgewater still going to play, to have Keenum there as your third slot is pretty awesome. There's not a lot of players of Case Keenum's caliber that are there as your third quarterback. I'm not saying dude is very good, but the guy's a veteran. He knows the plays. He knows everything that's going on. He sat on the bench long enough to fully get it. He starred in a few places. Yeah, they haven't been good. But with the defense around him, if we had to start him in a game, I wouldn't feel too bad. Would I think we'd win? No, but I don't think we would lose horrible because our defense is very, very good. Okay, so now we're going to go, we're going to talk about Anthony Barr. Exercise his fifth year option. And then we're going to talk about Xavier Rhodes. Re-signed him to a big money deal. We re-signed Everson Griffin to a big money deal. It's happening, folks. We just re-signed Joseph, defensive tackle. I'm going to butcher his name, but it's like Vindell Joseph. Messing up his name, and I know Remy and Ginger, my Minnesota homies, are going to be texting me right now and being like, you said dude's name wrong, but I'm sorry. But Linval Joseph, I think that's correct. Dude is a monster. Go check him out if you haven't. Dude's like a 325-pound, 6'4" freak. He just takes people out in the middle. He's one of the best run-stuffing defensive tackles in the league. Dude is a freak. Now, they just re-signed all this good talent around them. It means that this defense is going to be good for a very, very long time. And in football years, it's about 4 or 5 year window that they can actually do something here. So now it's going to flip it over to the offense. What did the Vikings do on offense besides we talked about the line? That looks a little bit better. So what did we do with running back then? Well, we signed freshly new Latavius Murray. And then we added Dalvin Cook in the draft. Dude is a freak. They're comparing this guy to a little Le'Veon. Now, I think he needs a little bit of work, but he is a stud. I'm hearing nothing but good things about him. And like we've talked about before, I think if Murray's healthy, which he just came back to camp today, he's playing, he looks like he's good. He felt good, he said. He was running fast. He was doing every single drill. So if he is healthy, he will start right away, in my opinion, because of what they paid him. You know, you got a veteran. He knows everything that's going on. But Dalvin will steal the job. Mark my words. By the end of this year, the starting running back will be Dalvin Cook. Okay? Go write that down, folks. I really believe that. And I like Murray. I just don't think he's the full package. And I think Dalvin has more potential to be the full package. So we'll see as it turns around. I think right now, as our quarterback, we have Sam Bradford still. I think is a good option as long as we keep him healthy. Because, man, we got Bradford, who's injury prone. He's healthy right now, so let's hope we keep him there. Then we got Teddy Bridgewater, and then Case Keenum at our third spot, which isn't good. It's not, but it isn't bad either. It's right in the middle. It's not good though. We don't want to start Case Keenum. If we want to make the playoffs, we have to have a healthy quarterback. Whoever, if Teddy comes back or if it's Bradford, and I like that because. Let's hope Teddy comes back soon and is just there. Is just there for us to actually back us up or start. I mean, who knows? If he comes back healthy, maybe he's got it. Maybe he doesn't. We will check it out, though. What do you guys think about the Minnesota Vikings? Do you think we're going to make the playoffs? Do you think they're not going to make the playoffs? What do you think their record is? I honestly think their record will be a respectable 10-6. We could go 11-5 if we can get past there's like a late season like our last, I want to say 8 or 6 games. It's tough. There is a lot of road games versus good teams. So if we get a quick road swing, you know, win a couple road games back to back or something, we could be 11-5. But I think a respectable 10-6. Go to the playoffs and try to get to the Super Bowl in your home city. I think that is the big thing that they want to do this year. And I think they're going to do anything they can to do it. They have the veterans. They have the young talent. They have everything put together. Now let's see what Mike Zimmer and his coaching staff can do. You know, this has been another great episode of the Fan Club. I know I was kind of everywhere tonight because of so many different topics, but I really appreciate you guys tuning in and like, subscribe, share, do it all. We love you. Thanks for tuning in.